Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about how to use Desmos, a free online calculator, to do your statistics homework. So desmos.com, and then I clicked on calculator when I got here. You can type that in and get directly here. What I'm going to do first is put in a data set. Notice how this pops up, and I could use this. I can always close that or open that keyboard as needed by clicking on that up and down arrow. I'm going to give my data set a name. You have to do that because when you ask it to do things, you have to be able to say what data set you're talking about. And then we use the bracket to show that. And right now it's saying, okay, you have a list, but there's nothing in it. So let's put a few values in it. Every time I enter a value, I put a comma. I'm just making up numbers. You can enter whatever list you have. Remember that as you enter your list, let's say you had 8 values, then when you're finished entering your values, you should just double check to make sure that you have 8 things in your list. So there's my list. I have 8 elements, so I know I got them all in there. The next thing I'm going to do is click below it to open a new box. And I can do a lot of different things with Desmos for free. And what I want to do is click on functions and then make sure you can use any of these buttons. But for our purposes, for these measures of center and variation, we're going to click on stats and you can see all the stuff that you have available to you. One that we use a lot is mean. If you click on the mean, you then have to say, I'm talking about data set A, boom, there's your mean. Make sure that you're rounding correctly when you're asked to give your answer. Maybe it's going to ask you to round to the hundredths. That would be 5.33. Always look at your directions about where to round. If you wanted to find standard deviation, here we go, STDEV. We want to always say that's our group A, and then boom, there's your standard deviation for that. If you want to find the quartiles, don't do that. Go to a new thing to find quartiles. Let's go back and put our standard deviation back in. Now I'm going to click below that to get my quartile. And let's say I want to know what the first quartile is. I just put in A, that's my data set, comma, 1 to show that I'm interested in the first quartile. That is the first 25%, where we are at the 25% mark. I can do quartile again. And this time do A, comma, 2. And that's a different number because I'm asking for a different quartile. So all your quartiles are there. Remember, to find variance, you just take your standard deviation to the second power. So when you look in here, you can find that variance. I keep doing that. We don't want to do that. But if you want to find variance, you can find it here. We're finding that of A. But also, you can always find that by squaring your standard deviation. I want to keep going out of that before you don't make that mistake every time. You can find your minimum and your maximum, but those probably aren't that useful when you have a small data set. But if you have a larger data set, that's very useful. And so I think that's where I'm going to leave it for this video. And have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.